Can a tiny chip keep your practice razor sharp? Watch me turn a 5-5-5 timer into a pro-grade metronome. Hey guys, in this video, I'm building an adjustable metronome with a 5-5-5 timer. No microcontrollers, no coding. Just clean, click-precise beats you can see and hear. Stay tuned to the second part of this video where I'll explain how this circuit works. I've packed my favorite 5-5-5 timer projects into a free ebook. Yep, totally free. Don't miss it. Click the link in the description to get yours. Here are all the components you need to set up this circuit. 5 alligator clips, 9 jumper wires, 1 potentiometer, 1 5-5-5 timer IC, a 1000 ohm resistor, 2 22 microfarad capacitors, a 9 volt battery buckle connector, a 9 volt battery, 1 5 watt speaker, a breadboard to connect everything together. The 5-5-5 timer IC comes with 8 pins. There is a notch or a dot on the chip's body. Pin 1, located at the top left, serves as the ground or ground supply. Pin 2 is trigger. It is used to start the timing interval in both monostable and astable modes. Pin 3 is output. It delivers the result of the timer's operation based on its mode, either monostable, astable, or bistable. Pin 4 is reset. It is used to reset the 5-5-5 timer's internal flip-flop. Pin 5 is control. It allows you to control the threshold voltage levels that the internal comparators use to set and reset the flip-flop. Pin 6 is threshold. It monitors the voltage of the capacitor connected to the circuit. Pin 7 is discharge. It controls the charge and discharge cycle of the timing capacitor. Pin 8 is VCC. It is responsible for supplying the power to the IC. Let's set up the circuit step by step. Begin by positioning the 5-5-5 timer IC on the breadboard. The pins are numbered counterclockwise, starting from the top left corner. Insert the 5-5-5 timer in the middle of the breadboard. A jumper wire connects pin 1 or ground to the negative rail. A jumper wire connects pin 8 or VCC to the positive rail. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 2 or trigger to pin 6 or threshold. Use a jumper wire to connect pin 4 or reset to pin 8 or VCC. Bend the ends of a 1000 ohm resistor. Insert a 1000 ohm resistor into pin 2 or trigger in pin 7 or discharge. Insert a 22 microfarad capacitor into pin 2 or trigger in the negative rail. The positive terminal is in pin 2. Insert a 22 microfarad capacitor into pin 3 or output, and a few rows below the 5-5-5 timer. The positive terminal is in pin 3. Insert a jumper wire into the same row as the capacitor. Attach the alligator clip to the other end of the jumper wire. Insert a jumper wire into the negative rail. Attach the alligator clip to the other end of the jumper wire. Attach the other ends of the alligator clips to the 5-watt speaker. Insert a jumper wire into the positive rail. Attach the alligator clip to the other end of the jumper wire. Attach the other end of the jumper wire to the right terminal of the potentiometer. Insert a jumper wire into pin 7 or discharge. Attach the alligator clip to the other end of the jumper wire. Attach the other end of the jumper wire to the left terminal of the potentiometer. Insert a jumper wire into pin 8 or VCC. Attach the alligator clip to the other end of the jumper wire. Attach the other end of the jumper wire to the middle terminal of the potentiometer. Connect the 9-volt battery buckle connector to the 9-volt battery. It's time to connect the power supply. Insert the positive lead to the positive rail. Insert the negative lead to the negative rail. We have successfully completed the circuit. Use the potentiometer to control the metronome speed. Turn the knob to the right to increase the beats per minute. Let's dive into the circuit and break it down step by step. This is a 555 timer metronome that generates periodic clicks in a speaker. The 555 is wired in a stable mode. Pin 2 or trigger and pin 6 or threshold are tied together and connected to the 22 microfarad capacitor C1. The other side of C1 goes to ground. A tempo network made of a potentiometer in series with a 1000 ohm resistor feeds pin 7 or discharge and pin 8 or VCC. With pin 4 or reset held at the 9-volt battery and pin 8 or VCC, the chip continually charges and discharges C1 between 1/3 and 2/3 of the supply. When the output at pin 3 is high, the internal transistor at pin 7 is off, so C1 charges from the supply through VR1 and R1. When C1's voltage reaches about 2/3 VCC, the 555 flips. The output goes low and pin 7 turns on, dumping charge from C1 through R1 until the voltage falls below about 1/3 VCC. That immediately flips the output high again, and the cycle repeats. The oscillation frequency is set mainly by VR1 and C1. Turning VR1 to a higher resistance lengthens the charge time and slows the beat, while turning it lower speeds the beat. R1 provides a minimum series resistance, so the discharge transistor isn't overstressed at very low VR1 settings, and it also defines the minimum period. The audible tick is created by coupling the 555's square wave output to the speaker through C2. C2 blocks DC, so the 5-watt speaker only receives brief current pulses at each output transition, which you hear as sharp clicks rather than a constant tone. The positive side of C2 is connected to the 555 output because the average DC level of the output sits around half the supply voltage, and the output pulses swing positive when the metronome produces each click. The speaker's return goes to ground, forming with C2 a simple high-pass path that emphasizes the attack of each beat. VR1 is your tempo knob, C1 sets the overall range, R1 protects the 555 and fixes limits, the 555 produces evenly spaced pulses, and C2 delivers those pulses to the 5-watt speaker as crisp metronome clicks. I hope this video has shown you how to make a metronome with a 555 timer. If you found this video helpful, give it a thumbs up, consider subscribing for more electronics tips and tutorials, and hit the bell icon to never miss an update. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.